Yeah. So now, if you observe here, in our today's class, we are going to study the next one, that is characteristics of weight. So please, all of you, keep heading characteristics of weight. Yes, in last class, I have taught you what is weight. So as we know, weight in the sense of what, guys? It is a kind of force only. Yes or no? So this force or weight of the object is depends on two factors. Can you say what is the two factors? This depends on two factors. One is mass of the body, and another one is acceleration
due to gravity.
But that is what we have been studied. So based upon this only, we have been concluded that the weight of a body, which is equals to, it is the product of what? Mass of the body and the acceleration due to gravity acting on that body is only called as weight of the body. Any doubt? Anybody? Please respond. So now let us come to here. As we know, this gravitational force is acting always what direction, guys? It is always acting what direction? It is always acting towards to the center of the body. Is it yes or no? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Always center of the body, towards to the center of the body, and always it is acting downward direction, always towards to center, towards to the center of the body. So that is why it is called as direction. Also, we are mentioning always towards to the downward direction. So that it is a vector quantity or scalar quantity. Anybody? Please respond.
Vector quantity.
So why it is called as vector quantity? Because along with the magnitude, we people are talking also about the direction. So that is why weight is called as what, guys? Weight is a vector quantity. But mass is what? What is mass? Mass is scalar quantity. Correct?
Scalar quantity.
Now, if any object you can drop from the certain height, always this object will fall towards to the center of the earth. Is it yes or no, guys? Always the pulling force is acting towards to the center of the earth only. So that is why this force we are talking about, it is acting towards the center of the earth. This is only called as what? Center of the earth. So it is acting downward direction or different directions? Always it is acting downward direction. That is what we can say gravitational force of earth, which is equals to 9.8 meter per second square, is always acting which direction, Tamil Selvam? It is acting always towards to the downward direction and towards to the center of the earth. So we are talking always direction. That is why along with the magnitude, so that we can say this is called as what, guys? It is what? Vector quantity. Understand? So vector quantity, because it is having what? Having direction towards
direction.
Direction towards to what?
Center of the
center of the object. But if we'll consider here earth, why we are living on the earth? Considering the earth. So somebody is making noise, please mute. That is, so now it is always acting towards the center of the object, and also acting which direction, Ra? Acting in vertically, which direction, upwards or downwards? Always
downward.
Acting vertically downward direction. Vertically downward direction. Understand? So that is why it is called as, it is which quantity we can say? Vector quantity. Please, all of you know it. Now, next, this is the first characteristics of weight. So now, next, second characteristic. So as we know, mass is measured by which balance, guys? What is the device which we can use for mass? Anybody, please?
Sir, beam balance.
Yes.
Beam balance.
Yes, beam balance also we can call it as what? Beam balance also.
Physical balance.
Physical balance. Yes or no? So now if you will observe very carefully, so the characteristics of weight, the beam, now coming to the weight of the body, we used to measure by a machine called as spring balance, or we can say weighing machine. So weight is measured with the what? It is measured measured with the spring balance. You people know it already. Have you heard it? It is actually spring balance, or we can say by a, what is that? Weighing machine. Weighing machine. So this is only called as measurement of weight. So this is what you have to remember. So as we know, this is the second characteristics. Now, what is the third characteristics? What do you mean by weight, guys? Can anybody say? Weight of the body is given by what? What is the formula? Weight of the body is given by always what?
Mass into acceleration.
Yes. Mass into acceleration due to gravity.
Weight of the body is given, understanding, by W is equals to, if you'll take capital W is equals to, what is that? It is a product of mass into, understanding, M into G. So here if you'll see, what is the G? G value is what? Acceleration due to gravity. Understanding? So acceleration due to gravity. That is what we should call as G. So now, this G is not constant from place to place. Understand? So this G changes from place to place. Then we can say the weight of the body changes from place to place. Understand everybody? So G is not constant. M is constant always. M is constant, but G is not constant. Is not constant from place to place. Place to place. So that what we can say, guys? What is that? So that weight of a body changes from place to place. So weight of body changes from place to place. Why? Because of what? Because of mass or gravity? Because of mass or gravity, guys?
Gravity, sir.
Gravity.
Gravity.
You have to remember. So please write this. This is what it is called. Clear? So now, if you notice it, sir, how sir it is. Now, as we know, this is which point, Elmukil? This is the third point. Yes or no? So now, it is how it is varies also. Already I have taught you the factors affecting gravity, altitude, depth, and the center of the earth. Have you not remember, guys? Please respond, others. Yes or no, others? So now, that points, let us discuss. When the gravity will increases? We know gravity is minimum at the where, guys? For example, if you take Earth. So as we know, Earth is not spherical shape. It is little at the poles, it is having flattened surface. So where we are having minimum gravity and maximum gravity, guys? So GM here,
minimum,
and here G is maximum. So G is minimum at where? At the equator, understand, and G is maximum at where, guys? Maximum at poles, understand, due to
poles.
Flattened surface there because of radius is decreasing. So radius at poles and radius at equator, we already know. So radius at equator is greater than radius at what, guys? Radius at poles. So that G at equator is less than G at poles. Is it okay, guys? Please respond. That is what we have been studying. So that is the first point. So that is why a body weighs more at the poles than at the equator. So if you'll measure the body weight, so where it will show more? Anybody?
Sir, at the poles only, sir.
Yeah, at poles it will show more. Is it yes or no?
More weight.
It will show more. And at the equator, the weight of the body will show less because G is minimum at equator and G is maximum at the poles. Clear? That is the first point. Next, second point. Now, the value decreases if you go away from it. Elevation. Anybody? Elmukil, Pradosh? Are you there in meeting, Maunish? If you go elevation from the ground, then what will happen? G value decreases or increases? Please respond.
Decreases, sir. Decreases.
Yes. Yes. So if you go elevation, height decreases. Understanding? G value decreases. This is only for MCQ. Decreases with the height. With what? Height. So if you keep on moving away from the ground, girls, nobody is there, away from the ground, then what is happening? G value is decreases. This height only we used to call one word. What is that called as? Altitude. What
altitude.
Is
altitude?
Altitude. That is you have to remember. So as we know, if your body is keep on, if you're going away from it, for example, let me take now any girl. Now, Alana, are you understanding, Alana? So this is what, let me imagine Earth. Now, this is the center of the Earth. Now, if you'll measure this girl, understanding, at this height, now this girl reaches to this height, this girl reaches to this height, so that weight is keep on decreasing or increasing. Anyhow, G is decreasing, so that what is happening? G is keep on decreasing, so that what is happening, guys? Weight is also keep on
also decreasing,
because both are directly proportional to each other. What is that, guys? Both are directly proportional to each other. So if you go higher elevations, if you go higher elevations, then what is happening? The weight of the body is keep on decreasing. So now, next, if you are keep on going deeper inside, for example, one girl is here. So now she traveled next level and she traveled next level. So as we know, this is only called as what, guys? Depth, we can
depth.
Say. Yes or no? So depth. Now here also, G value, what is happening, guys? If you keep on going depth inside, so G value is decreases, so that W value also what? W also
decreases.
So that is why weight also decreases, because gravity at depth is also inversely, sorry, directly proportional to weight of the body. So if you go higher elevations, altitude or depth, both G value is decreases. So as we know, W is also decreases. Are you clear till now? Any doubt, anybody, you can ask. Clear, guys? Adarshan, Shruti, Manyan, Samaya, Mahalakshmi, that is.
So understood, sir.
Yes, last point, if you'll see. Now, G value will become somewhere zero, guys. Can anybody say where it is G value will become zero? Please respond, everybody. G value will become zero. Some place.
When D became R.
Yes, when you reach to the center of the Earth, when you reach to the center of the Earth, the other, so if you speak only, it will come, remember. So now, if you reach to the center of the Earth, so exactly at the middle, center of the Earth, then in this case, what will become, guys? In this case, depth become radius of the Earth. Are you understanding? Depth become radius of the Earth. So we have remembered the formula also. What is the gravitational force formula for Helmholtz by this time? Maitreya and anybody? Gravitational force of Earth at the depth, which is equals to, what is the formula? Gravitational force of surface into 1 minus d by r. I know that. Now, if d become r, then what will come? G naught into 1 minus d by r. In place of r, what I can write? D only I can write. So, dd will get cancelled. So, I used to get how much? So, g naught into 1 minus 1, which is equals to what, guys? G naught into 0.
G naught into 0.
At the depth, where d become is equals to radius of the Earth, then gravitational force is 0 meter per second square.
0 meter per second square.
So, at the center of the Earth, what is the gravity? Gravity is 0. If gravity is 0, what is the weight of the body? If the gravity is 0, what is the weight of the body? So, weight of the body is equals to mass into gravity. So gravity is what? Gravity will become what?
Zero.
Gravity will become zero. So weight also will become what? Zero newton.
Zero.
Understand? So if it reaches to the center of the body, then the weight of any body will become zero. So this is what the characteristics of it. So now you can see mass of the body will become zero anytime. Last class, you can check your notebooks. Is it possible to make the mass of the
body
zero? Adarshan, Sai, mass of the body will never become zero. But weight of the body will become what? Shruti, weight of the body will become?
Zero.
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 Because gravity is not constant across the everywhere. If you are keep on going higher elevations also, weight is also decreases, because gravity is decreases. If you are going deeper inside the Earth also, gravity decreases, so that weight is decreases. And if it reaches to the exactly center of the Earth, then gravity will become zero. If gravity will become zero, then what about weight, guys? Weight also
zero.
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 So from this I can say, mass of a body is not zero. Mass of the body will never become zero, but weight of the body will become what? Weight of the body will become zero. Are you clear, everybody? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that is what,
sir,
everybody should remember. That is the difference between mass and weight. Mass and weight. Clear, everyone? So that is. So please note down. So these are the four characteristics of, sorry, three characteristics of weight. Under third characteristics of, again, how many subdivisions? A, B, C, and D. Four subdivisions are there. So please start writing from the first. Any doubt anybody can ask me. Why it is called as vector quantity? Prados, are you there in meeting? Dharun? Why it is called as vector quantity? Anybody can say? Because always it is acting towards the center of the earth.
Center of the earth.
In downward direction. So that is why it is called as vector quantity. Yes, please note it down. Write it. So I understand, Sai. Adarshan, respond me. So, right. This is what the characteristics. So all the characteristics is very, very important. So now, group, I will send you the difference between mass and weight. That same thing you people write it in the classwork. Okay. In exam, for example, it will come. Write the differences between mass and weight. Same thing you can follow. Is it okay, guys? Because we don't need to waste time. We'll proceed with that. So that is why you all should write your own. Okay. So please write it. I will send it in the group. You, according to that, you proceed. Okay. So now, after this, third point. This is what the third point. Third point, again, four subdivisions are there. All the subdivisions, you have to write it. So if you are going higher elevations, if you are staying on the surface, if you are moving, understanding, deeper inside the earth, and if it reaches to the center of the earth, what will happen? Each and every case, you have to write it. Aswita, you understand, Aswita? Alana?
Understood, sir.
Yes. Shruti, Manya and Samya? Yeah. My friend Prados not feeling well. Dharun, just inform him. Let him join.
Completed, sir.
Completed? All the four cases you have to complete. This is going higher elevations. Higher elevations they are going. And this is next one, going deeper inside the earth and finally reaches to what? Center of the earth. That is clear. So this is what you have to remember it. Now if you have remember, then from this we can write the formula. What is that formula, guys? Weight means in the sense of what? W, weight is equals to what, guys? What is the formula of weight? Weight W equals to mass of the body into gravity, acceleration due to gravity. So now, as we know, is it G is constant across the planet? Even Earth alone, it is not constant across the each place. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So G is not constant. G is not constant from planet and body to body. G is not constant for everybody. Do you understand? Body to body, the G value changes. So that is why, according to the body, we can modify this. For example, I will ask, weight of the body on earth, weight of the body on earth, which is equals to what will come? Mass of the body into acceleration due to gravity of what, guys? Acceleration due to gravity of earth, it will come. For example, if the same person will go to the moon, then what is the weight of the person in moon? Weight of the person in moon, which is equals to what will come? Mass of the
moon.
I understand? That is what you have to remember. So according to the formula, according to the planet, according to the body, our formula will be modified. So this is what you have to write it. Tamil Sanu, are understanding? So if you are calculating the weight of the body on earth, when we can say weight of the body on earth is equals to weight of mass of the body into gravitational force of the earth. Same way, if you are calculating the weight of the body on moon, then mass of the body into gravitational force of moon, we have to calculate it. This is what we can say. Now, if you'll understand this, now, as we know, we are living on the surface of earth. We are living on the planet called as earth, and the well-known satellite which is revolving around the earth is called as what, guys? Moon. Yes or no? So this is a natural satellite. So that is why we people need to know the gravitational force exerted by the moon also. So as we know, gravitational force of Earth, what is that, guys? The force exerted by the Earth is equals to 9.8 meters per second square. Yes or no? So now if you come to Earth, now Earth is exerting how much? That is what I need to know. So now let us come to here. How to find the gravitational force of moon is very simple. So as we know, just general formula, if you substitute, you will get the answer. So for example, we know what is the G formula, guys? Anybody can say? For example, gravitational force of moon, we want. What is the G formula? Anybody can say? Capital G
into M divided by R.
Moon divided by
radius,
radius of moon, moon square. Correct, guys? Square. The same formula. Yes, what is the general formula? Gm divided by R square. Is it SL Mokel?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now, if you notice it and you can tell me, so gravity of moon, which is equals to, what is the G value, guys? 6.7 into 10 power minus 11. Same way, what is the mass of moon? Anybody? What is the mass of moon? Mass of moon is 7.36 into 10 power 22 kilogram divided by, what is the radius of moon? Check in your textbook and you tell me. What is the radius of moon? 1.74 into
10 power 6 whole square.
This is what it is. So now, if you'll observe very carefully, if you'll solve this one, 6.7 into 7.36 into this one, how I can write, guys? You have to speak. 10 power minus 11 into 10 power
22
divided by this one, how I can write? 1.74 whole square. Into this one, how much, guys? 10 power 6.
10 power 2 all.
Whole square. Okay. Clear? Any doubt, anybody? You can ask. Which is equals to now 6.7 into 7.36 into this one, 10 power minus 11 into 10 power 22. This 10 power 6, what will come, guys? Can I write it as a 10 power 12? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
10 power 12 will come up. What will become? 10 power?
10 power minus 12.
Divided by 1.74 whole square. Clear, everybody? Any doubt? Manya and Samya? Shruti? So, if we'll solve this one, so 6.7 into 7.36, how much?
49.31.
Yes. So, 49.31. Others also solve it. So, 6.7 into, if you'll notice it, 6.7 into 7.36, which is equals to 49.31. Understand? Divided by 1.74 whole square, how much, guys?
1.74.
3.027. What it is? Yeah, 1.74 into 1.74. Please, all of you do it, which will give you how much? 3.02 into, now this one you can see, 10 power minus 11 minus 12 plus 22. How much, guys? So 12 plus minus 11 minus 23
minus 1
plus 22, which is equals to what?
10 minus 1, sir.
So
1, sir.
Minus 10 1. Power minus 1. Minus 1, not plus 1, Monish. That is. So now if you'll solve this one, so all of you solve this one, 49.31. divided by 49.39 divided by 3.02. How much, guys? 3.02. How much it is? 49.31 into, divided by 3.02, if we'll solve, we used to get how much? 16.32. Yes or no? Into 10 power minus 1. So
minus
into
10 1.
Power minus 1 means it will turn into what?
1.632 into 10 power 10.
What is that? Meter per?
Meter per second.
Meter per second square. This is what? Gravitational force of what, guys? Gravitational force of? Moon. Understand, everybody? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So solve this one. So 1.632. Please make it. Others also solve.
Please scroll up, sir.
Yes, yes. Gravitational force of moon. Okay. Clear, guys?
Sir.
Hello, Gil. So, as we already know, you already solved it. I know that, but I will say in another different method to make you satisfy. Okay? To make it very simple also. So, now, if you notice it, in our textbook, you can see finding the weight ratio of moon and the earth, they have solved very big calculation. They have substituted mass of the earth, mass of the moon, radius of the earth, radius of the moon, etc., etc. Can you say the page number, Mukil, please? Or Lakshya? Anybody? You both already, you know already. I know that. Mukil, can you say the page number? If you have the book. So, if not, also no problem. Now, observe carefully, guys, everybody. This is what the gravitational force of moon. Is it yes, guys? Respond. Now, if you know, guys, so try to multiply this number with 6. Everybody, try to multiply with 6 and tell me what is that it will come. Sai, please try to multiply it and tell me what it will come. So, if you multiply 1.632 into 6, try to multiply and you will get
9.
Yes.
9.7.
9. Very good. Tell me.
9.78, sir.
Yes. So we used to get 9.79 will come. So can I write as a, which is equals to 9.8? Yes or no, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So have you noticed it? This is what we should call it as gravity of moon. Understanding? And into 6. This is what we should call it as what, guys? This is called as gravity of earth. That's all. This is what I want to get the relation. So gravity of earth is how many times more than the gravity of moon, guys? How many times it is?
Six times.
It is more than gravity of moon. That is what I want to say. Are you clear, everybody? So gravity of moon into 6 will give you gravity of earth. So you can say meter per second square, and here also meter per second square. So if you take the gravity of moon, understanding, then the gravity of earth is 6 times more than that. Now from this, suppose I want gravity of moon. Now here 6 is in multiplication. Will come this side, what will become, guys? So gravity of moon is equals to gravity of earth divided by 6. Are you okay, guys? Please respond. This is what you have to remember it. So gravity of moon is equals to gravity of earth divided by 6. Same way, gravity of earth is equals to 6 times of gravity of moon. Aswita, Alana, are you understand, Alana? Yes, that is what you have to remember. So gravity of earth is equals to gravity of moon into how much? Gravity of moon into 6 times. That is how to find it. Clear, guys? Any doubt in this, you can ask.
No, sir.
Okay. So, if you'll understand it, Monish, Tamil Selvan, Maitreyan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, now, if you'll understand this,
yes, sir,
we are going to study the very important and very interesting one, that is, so as we know, gravity ratio we have been found. What is the ratios of gravity as gravity of earth and gravity of moon? Can anybody say ratio?
Gravity ratio.
If we take gravity ratio of, please observe, gravity ratio of moon and earth. Moon and earth, which is equals to what, guys? Gravity of moon divided by gravity of earth. How much, guys? Gravity of moon is 1.632 divided by gravity of earth is how much? 1.8. You will get it. What is the ratio?
1 by 6.
Yes or no, guys? Please respond.
Sir.
So the ratio, gravity ratio of moon is to gravity ratio of earth, which is equals to 1 is to 6. Yes, so that is what we have been concluded. Now, same way as we know gravity ratio, we have been found. Now, we know that one factor is constant, one factor is varies. What is that factor? Mass is constant.
Mass constant.
Yes, mass on the moon is also constant. Mass on moon and mass on earth. Both yes. It is what? Both it is constant. What? It is always constant. But what? Who is varying? Who is varying?
Gravitational force.
Gravity of earth and the moon.
So gravity is varying means who is varies? Weight. Understanding? So weight is also weight on moon. Weight on moon and weight on earth. Is what? Not
varies.
Is not constant. But how many times it is varies? So how to find it? That is what we are going to derive now. Like gravity ratio. Is it any ratio for weight also? We'll see. So that is what, please all of you keep heading. Heading. Weight of an object on the moon. Weight of an object. If we'll take any object. Right. Please keep heading. Weight of an object, weight of an object on the moon is 1/6 of, how much it is? 1/6 of its weight. Its weight on the earth. Is it okay, guys? Weight on the
earth.
Any doubt? Anybody, you can ask. Clear? This is what it is.
No.
Now we are going to prove. So as we know, gravity is 1/6. So they are saying what here, Maitreya? They are saying weight is also 1/6 of its on the earth. So now we are going to prove that relation, either it is true or not. So how to see? So we can easily find it. So as we know, please tell me, what is the weight formula first? First of all, what is the weight formula, Monish? Tamil Selvan.
Weight is equal to mass into gravity.
Mass into gravity. Now, we are studying about what? Moon and earth. So, weight on moon is equals to what? Weight on moon is equals to mass of the body into gravity of moon. Same way, weight on earth is equals to what, guys? Weight on earth is equals to what?
Mass into gravity of earth.
Gravity of earth. So, as we know, what is the G formula? G formula what? G is equals to capital G into
capital M divided by R square.
Divided by R square. Okay. So now, can I write the formula? In place of G, can I substitute it or not? So weight of the G equals. So what will come formula? M into, in place of G, what I can write? Capital G into capital
M divided by
R square. Correct? So now, from this, I can say weight on moon is equals to, what will come? M into capital M into, what is the M? Mass of moon. Mass of moon divided by what will come, guys? Radius of moon
divided by whole square.
Radius of moon, whole square. Same way, weight on earth is equals to what will come? Weight on earth is equals to what will come? M into capital G into weight of mass of earth. Mass of earth divided by what will come?
Radius of earth
whole square. Clear, Almukil? Till here you have been solved. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt? Anybody can ask me. Clear, guys?
Yes,
so,
sir.
So let assume MM means mass of the body, mass of moon. Is it okay, guys? Mass of moon. ME means what? Mass of earth. What do you mean by small m? Mass of body. What is that? Mass of body. Clear, guys? Any doubt in this?
Body.
No. So now, let us imagine this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Clear? Equation number 1 and equation number 2. Now, divide equation number 1 with equation number 2. Divide equation 1 with the equation 2. Please all of you tell. So what is the equation 1? Weight on moon. Is it yes or no? Nobody will answer. Yes. What is the second one? Weight on?
Earth.
Weight on earth. So now, can I write it? Weight on moon is equals to weight on moon divided by weight on earth Kelvokil, I will make you without calculations. I will teach you now. Okay. Weight on moon divided by weight on earth is equals to what is the formula? Weight on moon. Respond. Capital G into capital M M into small m divided by
R square.
Whole square.
R M square.
Divided by next weight on earth is equals to you should speak capital G into capital M E into small m divided by
R whole square.
Yeah. Till here this step any doubt? Please others also respond. Is it till here any doubt? No.
No, sir. Yes.
Now this one I can write as a G M M M small m divided by R M whole square. It is
square.
Don't write side, subscript. Don't get confused. Is it okay? If you'll write side, what will happen, Elvokil, here? If you'll write side, then it will become GMM. Yes or no? M, M, M.
Yes, sir.
Be careful. It is moon. Moon. What is that? Moon. Okay?
Moon.
It is division is again having division. Elvokil, what will turn situability into this? Maitreya and Tamil Selvan? It will turn RE whole square divided by G.
M,
M. M. Clear, guys? Now, here one term is constant. What is the term? Can you see anybody? Something is constant.
G and the M, sir.
Yes. G is constant. G is constant. Can I get cancelled? And same way, yes, mass, sir, of the body is constant. Mass of the body is constant. So, can I get cancelled it or not, guys?
Yes, sir.
Now, finally, I used to get. What is remaining? Please check it and tell me. What is remaining? Mass of moon.
Mass of moon into
mass of moon square. Divided by radius of moon whole square.
Mass of earth. Can I take mass of earth? Mass of earth into this one is radius of earth whole square divided by
radius of the moon whole square.
Moon whole square. Any doubt till here? Please respond. Clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, let us imagine this is what equation number 3. What I can assume? Equation number 3. Or else you can write this one as MM. MM means what, guys? MM means what? Mass of moon into this one I can assume. Understanding? Both squares. Can I write as a RE by RM? RE by
whole square.
Whole square. Very good, Monish. Maitreyan, are you understand, Maitreyan? RM by whole square. Is it okay, guys?